فيقول هذا أن لا نريد من هؤلاء شيء، أي الجيل الأول، لأن الجيل الأول يعتبر جيل متعصب. نريد الجيل الثاني، أولاد هؤلاء، أولاد هؤلاء لنا، وأنتم لا دخل لنا بكم.
So these disbelievers, those people who plot and think in these ways, they say, look, we don't want anything from the first generation. The first generation, they're stubborn on what they are upon. But we want the next generation down. We want to get the children of this generation. The children of this generation, they're for us, meaning they're within our plots. But the first generation, we don't want anything from them. So the child, he grows up. He doesn't know anything about Islam.
ولا عن الرب.
He doesn't know anything about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
ولا عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
He doesn't know anything about the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام.
لا يصلي.
He doesn't pray.
لا يصوم.
He doesn't fast.
لا يخرج الزكاة.
He doesn't give his zakah.
بل أنه يلبس الصليب.
But rather, instead of this, he wears the cross.
ويشرب الخمر ويصنع ويصنع ويصنع.
And he drinks alcohol and he does and he does and he does.
ما الفرق بينك وبين الكافر؟
So what is the difference between him and the disbeliever?
أنه مسلم ميم سين لام ميم، يعني لا يعرف شيء عن الإسلام إلا هذه الحروف، لا يعرف حتى ما هو الإسلام.
So what is the difference between this person and the disbeliever? That this person is a Muslim. ميم سين لام and ميم. Meaning he knows nothing about Islam except these four letters.
هذا هو الإعراب عن دين الله بالكلية الذي أراد أعداء الإسلام أن نصل إليه ويصل أولادنا إليه. لا تعلموا شيء عن الدين.
So this is the meaning of al-i'rad, completely turning away and being distant from the religion of Allah. And this is what the disbelievers want from us and our children. That our children, they do not know anything about the religion of Islam.
نعم. ثم أن المؤلف رحمه الله بعد أن ذكر هذه النواقض أراد أن يبين شيء من ما يقع فيه الناس، نسأل الله السلامة العافية، وأراد أن يبين أن هذه النواقض ليست محصورة بعشر نواقض. نعم. فقال:
So after this, after the author has finished mentioning the 10 matters which invited a person to Islam, he wanted to mention other things that people commonly fall into. And that the matters which invalidate a person to Islam are not limited to 10 numbers. So he said,
نعم.
He said, there's no difference in all of these matters which invalidate a person's Islam, whether a person is doing them in jest, hazil, or with intent, والجاد أو خائف or out of fear, except if a person is مكره, he is compelled to do them.
ذكرنا فيما تقدم في المستهزئ.
We have mentioned previously regarding the person who mocks.
قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاث جدهن جد وهزلهن جد، ولهذا قال لا فرق بين الجاد والهازل لأنه شيء واحد على ما ذكر النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
We have mentioned previously regarding the person who mocks or makes a mockery of Islam or Allah or His Messenger, that the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whereby he said the three matters when they are done in seriousness, they are taken as being serious, and even when they are done in jest or joking or lightly, then they are still taken as being serious.
وقصد المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى هنا بالخائف قال إلا المكره. الإكراه شيء والخوف أي الخوف على المناصب وعلى الجنسية مثلا، على ما تسمع من بعض الناس يخاف أن تأخذ منه الجنسية الكافرة ولهذا ينهى الأولاد عن الصلاة وعن تعلم الدين، يعني يأمر الأولاد بالإعراض عن دين الله بالكلية من أجل الخوف على الجنسية أو ما إلى ذلك، أو أن له منصب في بلاد الكفر.
So the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, in the next bit he differentiated between a person who does these actions out of fear or somebody who is compelled to do them. And he said that there's a difference between a person who does it out of fear and somebody who's compelled or forced to do an action. So for example, a person, he distances his children from the religion of Islam, or he forbids them from praying. Why? Because he fears that he's going to lose a position of authority, or he fears that his nationality is going to be taken away from them.
استثنى المكره.
And the author, the only exception he made was for the person who is compelled or forced to do these actions.
مكره. اشترط العلماء رحمه الله تعالى في المكره أمور.
The scholars, they have mentioned that when it comes to a person who is forced or compelled, then they have stipulated a number of conditions.
الأول أن يكون مكره.
Number one, firstly, that he is indeed compelled or forced.
وأنت تعرف أن بعض الناس يعني غير مكره ولا أحد يكره على هذا. نعم. وهو الذي يعني يصنع هذه الأشياء عن اعتقاد وعن خوف على الجنسية وعلى المنصب أو على ما إلى ذلك. نعم.
And you find some people that despite they claim that they are compelled or forced, they're not compelled or forced. Rather, they just do something because of just fearing, again, a nationality being taken away or some type of position being taken away from them.
يعني نتحقق الإكراه.
Meaning that الإكراه, the force or the compulsion has to be actualized.
يعني إما أن تفعل هذا أو تقتل.
Meaning that somebody says to the person that either you do this action or you'll be killed.
الثاني.
Secondly.
إلا من أكره وقلبه مطمئن بالإيمان.
That now the second condition is that the person who is compelled, as Allah said in the ayah, that the person is except the person is compelled while his heart is tranquil with iman.
ولا أحد يدري عما في القلب إلا الله.
And nobody knows that which is in the heart except Allah.
ونحن نرى أو نعلم أن هناك بعض الناس هدانا الله وإياهم يغير حتى ما في قلبه ويقول أنه مكره. نعم.
And we know of some people who will even change that which is in their own hearts just to say that they are compelled.
ثم الإكراه أيضا لا يكون في تعدي على غيره.
And then being forced to do an action or being compelled to do an action, this doesn't mean that you now oppress or exceed the limits of somebody else, oppress somebody else.
يعني هذا مثلا أكره على قتل هذا.
So for example, this one, he was forced or compelled to kill this one.
فهل له أن يقتل هذا حتى يبقي على نفسه؟
So is it permissible for him to kill this person so he can save himself?
لا.
No.
لأن هذا يتعدى إلى غيره.
Because now he is oppressing and taking the right of this one.
أحمد رحمه الله عندما أكره على القول بخلق القرآن هل أحمد رحمه الله كان مكره؟ نقول لا، ليس له أن يقول بهذا، لأنه لو قال هذه الكلمة لتعدى هذا إلى غيره وظلت الأمة. نعم، ولهذا سمي الإمام أحمد بإمام أهل السنة والجماعة. نعم، لأنه وقف ضد الفتنة. نعم.
So Imam Ahmad, he was compelled and forced to say that the Quran is created in his time. And did Imam Ahmad rahimullah do this? No. Because if he did this, if he thought that he was compelled and forced to do this, then this would have oppressed other people. Why? Because the other people would have been misguided. And therefore, he didn't say this, even though he was forced to do it. And for this reason, Imam Ahmad, may Allah have mercy upon him, he was called the Imam of Ahl Sunnah.
كذلك لا يزيد.
And also a person doesn't exceed the limits.
يعني أكره على سب رجل واحد من المسلمين.
Meaning, a person is compelled or forced to insult one particular Muslim.
فسب عشرة أو مئة أو كل أهل الإسلام.
So therefore he begins to insult 10 or 100 all of the people of Islam.
نقول أنت مكره على واحد أما البقية لست مكره عليهم فتؤاخذ بهذا.
We say to him that you were forced or compelled to insult one person, but you weren't forced or compelled to insult all of the people of Islam, and therefore you will be taken upon this.
ثم أيضا قال العلماء رحمه الله في المكره أنه يعرض ما استطاع يعني لا يصرح بالكفر يعني يأتي بأمور يعني هي في الظاهر أن هؤلاء يصدقوه على ما أكره عليه وهو في هذا الكلام ليس بناطق بالكفر. نعم مع أنه مكره، لكن مع هذا يعرض، كما في فتنة الإمام أحمد رحمه الله، كان العلماء الذين يعني كان في حقهم أنهم على الإكراه كانوا يقولون التوراة والإنجيل والزبور هذه أي الأصابع مخلوقة، واقصد بهذا الأصابع، وكان هؤلاء يعني من أكرههم يظن أنهم أرادوا القرآن والكتب المنزلة من السماء. نعم.
And also the scholars they have mentioned, may Allah have mercy upon them, regarding a person being compelled and forced, that even though a person is compelled or forced to do an act of kufr or say a statement of kufr, that he tries to resist as much as possible or tries to find a way out as much as possible, even by saying something which they think that he has said a word of kufr, but in reality he hasn't said it. Like for example that which occurred at the time of Imam Ahmad, when the people were forcing Imam Ahmad to say that the Quran...
Imam Ahmad, الَّذِينَ مَعَ الْإِمَامِ أَحْمَدِ.
When the people were forcing the scholars who were with Imam Ahmad to say that the Quran is created, they would say the Quran and the Torah and the Injil, these are created. And they were referring to their fingers being created, not the Quran and the Torah and Injil.
نعم ثم إن تحققت هذه الشروط فهو مكره.
So then if these conditions are fulfilled and met, then we can say that this person has been compelled or forced.
نعم ذكر الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى في مسألة يعني حلق اللحى في بعض الدول.
Ibn Uthaymeen رحمه الله mentions regarding the issue of being forced to shave the beard in some countries.
يقول الإشكال في أول من حلق اللحية أنه تجرأ وحلق اللحى ثم بعد هذا سنة سيئة فتابعوه الناس على هذا. نعم.
He said,
لو صبر لبقي الكل. نعم.
الشيخ ابن عثيمين رحمه الله said, then this issue, the real problem is the first person who shaved his beard when he was pressurized to do so. And had he been patient and not done so, then people wouldn't have followed him. But because he gave up and he shaved his beard, he therefore introduced an evil action, and therefore people followed him.
ولا يفهم هذا الخروج على الحكام، لكن يفهم من هذا أن بعض الناس لأدنى أذية أو أدنى ضرر يترك كل الدين. والله سبحانه وتعالى قال: ومن الناس من يقول آمنا بالله فإذا أوذي في الله جعل فتنة الناس كعذاب الله، أي جعل الخوف من الناس أشد من الخوف من الله. نعم.
And this doesn't mean that a person starts rebelling against the Muslim rulers. What this means is that some people, any little harm that comes to them, they completely turn away from the religion of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said regarding those people who, when they are tested or afflicted by something, that they consider the fear that they have of the people is greater than the fear that they have of Allah.
نعم. والطاعه في المعروف ولا طاعه لمخلوق في معصيه الخالق.
And obedience can only be done in goodness, and there is no obedience to creation when there is disobedience to the creator.
فنسمع ونطيع ما لم نؤمر بمعصية.
So we hear and we obey as long as we are not ordered to do an act of disobedience.
نعم. ثم قال رحمه الله تعالى.
And then after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, said that all of these matters, وكلها, and all of these matters are the most dangerous and yet most common of what takes place.
نعم. هذا فيه شاهد أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى يرى أن النواقض ليست محصورة بعشرة. نعم.
So in this
من
is
أعظم ما يكون ومن هذه تبعيضية. نعم.
So in this is an evidence that the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he considers that these 10 matters which invalidate a person's Islam, they only 10 from many more matters which invalidate a person's Islam. And the min that was used here, وَكُلُّهَا مِنْ أَعْظَمْ, is min التبعيضية, meaning that he's saying that these matters are from more matters. There are more matters than these are from amongst them.